हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक टू डिस्कस, दैट इज क्लासिफिकेशन एंड एवोल्यूशन। इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। दैट मीन्स व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन क्लासिफिकेशन एंड एवोल्यूशन, दैट मीन्स ग्रुपिंग, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स, हाउ डू वी क्लासिफाई लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड द एवोल्यूशन। And what is evolution? Actually, the term evolution, it was first uh, 1859 by Darwin. Darwin have given the idea regarding the evolution. And what is the evolution? Actually, the process of gradual changes. Gradual means very slow changes in living organism. That means in all living organisms, automatically some slow changes come, very slow changes come in organism over millions of years, which are actually existing in organisms over millions of years. That means in our ancestors, their ancestors, their ancestors, and resulted in the present day living organisms. These gradual changes, these slow changes, when they occur in living organism, they get accumulated means they get added. When a living organism before millions of years some changes, for example one change added to it in his or in her in offspring, another change in its offspring, another change, and hundreds of changes are present in the present day living organism. That means these changes, the process of gradual change in living organisms over millions of years, the very slow changes or slow process through these slow changes occur in organisms and resulted in the present day living organisms. The organisms which you are seeing present day times, these organisms are actually the result of these changes which took place for millions of years ago. And the next point is the body design of living organisms are gradually changing due to the change in environment and adapt themselves to the changes. An important point is that these changes which occur in living organisms, every body design of organ, the body of an every organism are gradually changing. That means the bodies also, the bodies of organisms are also changing due to the changes in environment. Why bodies of organisms are changing? Due to the changes in the environment. Environment is also flexible, environment also changes, our environment also changes during the time, or you can say before millions of years the environment was not such which is present day environment, and these changes in the environment force an organism to change its body and adapt themselves to the changes, and the organisms adapt themselves to the changes in the environment. Next point is, if some groups of organisms have ancient body designs. Ancient means very primitive. Primitive means the old body design. Those are some organisms which are even present today. They have some ancient body design, old body designs. Oh, that means they are not very complex organisms. And these organisms are known as primitive organisms. What are primitive organisms? These are the organisms which are having old body designs, or you can say ancient body designs. Next is, some organisms have acquired their body design relatively recently and are complex. The organisms, some organisms due to these changes, they have acquired their body changes, and the body is relatively adapted to the newer environments, and due to these changes the body design is modern body design, or you can say recent body design, and are complex. But the body of an organism is complex, and those organisms which have complex body which have acquired the body designs with respect to the environment. And during this period, the body design evolved from simple to complex organisms, or simple to complex body design. Such organisms are known as advanced organisms. If we talk about, for example, advanced humans are the advanced Homo sapiens. These are advanced organisms. Humans, birds are advanced organisms. Mammals are, we are all mammals. Advanced organisms. The primitive organisms are like bacteria. They are primitive organisms. Bacteria. They are primitive organisms. These primitive organisms have body design very simple, and the complex body designs are present in the modern day, or you can say the advanced organisms. And these, that means through these processes, the time is very important. Time. That means due to the passage of time, the complexity of living organisms has increased from simple to complex. From simple to complex. And now we have to classify, we have to make groups of organisms. Groups of organisms. If we make groups on the basis of some characters which we discussed yesterday, the criteria, mode of nutrition, that. But that type of classification is not a true classification which truly categorizes, which truly divides the group of living organisms from the other on the basis of these some characters. But without considering the concept of evolution and classification, the classification is not complete. So the scientists in modern times, the scientists have accumulated, or you can say scientists have related the process of evolution with the classification, so that the classification becomes more and more valid through these evolutionary processes, because the relation is between organisms are understood by the evolutionary processes. Therefore, the classification and evolution have very important relation. That means without evolution, we cannot classify organisms into different groups which are having true relationships, or you can say relationships which can have true relationships. And nowadays the classification also is based on ontogeny. Actually, it is the embryonic development. And next is phylogeny means evolutionary relationships. And these evolutionary relationships show us that the mammals have originated from the reptiles, birds have originated from the reptiles have originated from these amphibians. This relation and embryonic development, that if you will see the embryo of humans, of certain human embryo and chicken embryo, at certain time you will see some similarity between the two at certain stages. That means the embryonic development also shows us the relation between the different groups of organisms, so that we can classify them accordingly. This was about the classification and evolution. Thank you.